गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद अवर नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स फैक्टर्स एंड मल्टीपल्स एक्सरसाइज नंबर 18. सो सम नंबर्स वुड बी गिवन टू अस एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड ऑल द फैक्टर्स ऑफ दीज नंबर्स. सो लाइक क्वेश्चन नंबर फर्स्ट ए पार्ट इज देयर. द नंबर इज 10. यू हैव टू राइट ऑल द फैक्टर्स. सो वन ऑन द टेबल ऑफ वन 10 गोज. So 10 is divided by 2 also, 5 also and 10 also. So these are the factors. So you can write as factors of 10 are like this. Okay. And D part. It is 29 na. 29 goes on the table of 1 and 29. So these are the two factors of 29. You can also take the example of this C part 22 na. So it goes on the table of 1, 2 also. It is divided by 11 also and 22 also. So there are four factors. Question number second, find the number of factors of each. That means we have to find the number of factors. So part A is there 12 na. Question number second. The 1 is a factor of 12, 2 is a factor of 12, 3 is a factor of 12, 4 is a factor of 12, 6 is a factor of 12, 12 is a factor of 12. So how many factors are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 factors are there. So you have to count the number of factors. So question number B part is 19. So it goes on the table of 1, it goes on the table of 19. So two factors are there. And here next is 43, E part, 43. So it goes on the table of 1. So it goes on the table of 43. So two factors are there. So you have to find the factors and you have to calculate the factors. There are two terms in mathematics. One is prime. There are some numbers are prime numbers and some are composite numbers. So what are the prime numbers? So the number which is having only two factors, like 17 is there. 1 is a factor of 17 and 17 is a factor of 17. That number is a prime number. And composite number which is having like 8, more than 2 factors, 2, 1, it goes on the table of 1 also, it goes on the table of 2 also, it goes on the table of 4 also, it goes on the table of 8 also. So there are two factors, mainly 1, and the number itself is a factor of it. Okay. So you have to find whether a number is a composite number or whether a number is a prime number. So look at the question number 3. There are some numbers which are given to us like 27, 46, 59, 63, 73. You have to find whether it's a prime number. If it is having only two factors, the number itself is a factor and 1, then it's a prime number. Otherwise, it's a composite number. So part A is there. So third part A, the number is 27. It is divided on 1. It is 1 is a factor of 27. 3 is a factor of 27. Okay. And 9 is a factor of 27. And 27 is a factor of 27. So it is not a prime number. It is a composite number. So you will write like that. It is a composite number. B part is there, 46, it goes on the table of 1, 2 also, and 23 also, and 46, okay. So it is also a composite number. So it is a composite number. So 59 is a number. Okay. So it goes on the table of 1 also, and it goes on the table of 59. So it's a prime number. So it has only two factors, no? The number itself is a factor and 1 is a factor. So it's a prime number. Definitely it's a prime number. And there is a e part is there, 73. So it goes on the table of 1 also, it goes on the table of 73 also. So it's also a prime number. So question number 4th. So you would find the numbers would be given to you. You have to find the prime factors. You have to find the prime factors by using two methods. The first method name is division method, and second method name is tree method. So just number 24 is given to you. Just divide this 24. It goes on the table of 2. 12 would come. It goes on the table of 2. 6 would come. 3, 1. So these are the prime factors of 24. So 24 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 1. So tree method is also there. First you would write 24. Now break this 24, how? 2 into 12. This is kind of a tree. Now break this 12. 2 into 6. Now break this 6. 2 into 3. Now break it 3. You have to break till 1 comes. So these are the branches of a tree. So 24 is equals to 2. Multiply 2, multiply 2, multiply 3. So this is the answer. So J part is also there, 216. So break it. Okay, it would be 108. Again break it, 54, again break it, 27, again break it, 9, again break it, 3, again break it, 1. So 216 is equals to 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 multiply 3 multiply 3 multiply 3 into 1. So these are the prime factors of 216. Now you would find the prime factor using tree method. Break it. 2 multiply 108. 2 multiply 54. 2 multiply 27. So break this 27. 3 into 9. So break this 9. 3 into 3. So break this 3, 3 into 1. So you will stop when 1 comes here. So you will write the prime factors 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So this is the answer. So you are finding the prime factor with the help of division method and with the help of tree method. Question number 5, the blanks are there. The only even prime number is 2. And the smallest prime number is, smallest prime number, that is 1. And every number is having a same factor. 1 is the factor of every number, you know that. And co-prime numbers are, what are the co-prime number? So co-prime numbers are which are having a HCF of 1. So this is like 5 is also a prime number and 7 is also a prime number. It goes on the table of 1, it goes on the table of 5. It goes on the table of 1, it goes on the table of 7. The common highest common factor is 1. If two prime numbers, they are having highest common factor as 1, they are known as the co-prime numbers. Co-prime numbers. So the smallest co-prime number is 1 and 3. Okay. Each prime number has exactly how many factors? 2 factors. The number itself and the 1 as a factor. Thank you and have a nice day.